You know that feeling when you're looking forward to a new release, maybe a new flagship camera's coming, and then the company releases something worse than they already have? It reminds me of a story of this guy who got lost in the desert. And he's like, oh shit, where's my, I have no idea where I am, it's hot, I'm gonna die here. And he's panicking and he breaks open a cactus for water. He's like, oh wow. And it was like acid and he was like, ow. And he like had to open his mouth with his fingers. He had to poke new mouth holes. That's basically what this black magic piece of shit is. Acidic mouth holes from a cactus.
All I want is the perfect camera. All I want is the perfect camera.
So as a cinematographer who makes talking head videos in his living room and sometimes makes vlogs on the way to the grocery store, I need a cinema cam. So I was debating, do I get the Canon C500 Mark II, maybe an Alexa of some sort used? That would bring Blackmagic into the equation. I've been hoping, I was just thinking the other day, I'm like, I wonder if they're working on something. They were. But not what we wanted. When I saw that Blackmagic actually released something, my eyes perked up. I was like, I start reading the specs. I'm like, oh. Your face shouldn't change from hope to despair so quickly in a release. You had to bring that to the marketing board. Did you have a meeting about it? I swear if there was a meeting. All right, fellas, we're in last place. We're the least known camera company of all the camera companies, and it's embarrassing, and I'm sick of it. Let's release something that knocks doors off of people's houses. Who has the first idea?
Boss, you have no idea how excited I am that you asked this. I've been working on this for years. Full frame sensor, Sony E mount, electronic variable ND, auto exposing everything. We keep our 180 degree shutter rules so cinematic. Variable electronics in there. Flippy screen. Big, giant flippy screen. We're done. Done.
Candace, your misplaced enthusiasm is cute, but I don't have a map to a secret pyramid in the Antarctic region that would house alien technology that could accompany your needs. Just sit down and shut the
Boss, we better bring the heat on this one. I'm sick of being second place in a world of misfits. I'd have slapped you in the face.
Oh no.
Slap you like this? 8K, 240p, with a Sony E mount, you piece of shit.
Calm down. Let's just release something worse than what we already have for less money. It's a good business model. It doesn't excite anybody. It's a lot of disappointed kids at Christmas, but people could actually afford it. With inflation these days, this fits. It fits in our life path. Relax, you crazy wicked bitch. So here's the deal with this release. There's some interesting things. It's better than the 6K, but worse than the 6K Pro. You're probably excited about this gyro data. Let me tell you why that's awesome and terrible. One, we know it's gonna take time to process. That's annoying. Two, it will crop in and degrade your image. Sony Catalyst Browse just destroys footage. It takes 4K and turns it into like slightly worse than 1080p. I don't know how that happens. It's just a crop, a little 15% crop. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. It says image quality enhanced, preferred. So I click something like that. So it's gonna take time to use, it's gonna look worse, and if you're doing something like wildlife, you have to have no stabilization. So you have to turn lens stab off for this gyro data to work. Do you have any idea how hard it is to manually focus and keep something in the frame without any stabilization? It's like shaking all over the place, it's impossible. So like, this is not gonna be good for wildlife cinema, that's for sure. So I don't know if you're just like following your girlfriend in a forest for those important shots, it might work. Hope she leaves you. If I was president or king of Blackmagic, I would either You have to switch that mount. Why do you have an EF mount? I know there's probably some deep mafia Yakuza shit that prevents you from using other mounts. I get it. That doesn't stop me from dreaming. But the EF mount, it's like these old DSLR lenses, so heavy. If you're doing wildlife, super heavy. If you're not, still heavy. Slow autofocus motors, like, the technology is old. Why are you having that mount? It's the dumbest mount. It was so much better with the Micro Four Thirds mount. Then you get some, at least some tiny lenses. Or you could speed boost your way to the EF mount if you had to. But this whole EF mount native needs to die. In a perfect world, this is a Sony E mount, and it's a full frame sensor. Or a Super 35, I don't mind you. I don't mind you, there's movies. There's been at least 7 movies shot on a Super 35 sensor. I've seen 6 of them. They were good. E-mount is like the best. Can you imagine Black Life? That's not the name of their company, but it should be. Blackmagic matters. You get a Sony 200 to 600. Fucking flip up screen, that giant thing. Wow. Imagine I could have this Sony 20mm 1.8 at 2.8, of course. I have discipline now. See what could have happened? It's too much. Too much tone. Don't be so rude. In fact, 24 for the rest of the video. I regret that decision. Imagine this in a Blackmagic, more cinematic skin tones, better colors. It wouldn't change your life at all. I don't deserve it. When I think of Blackmagic cameras, I'm hoping either they take it into a wildlife territory or a YouTuber's territory. If it's a YouTuber's type of camera, which it almost is, just flip the screen towards me somehow. I don't need autofocus. If we're doing that, it's like, okay, I'm manually focusing. I could do that on this. Okay, I've just stopped it down. We're out. We're in that background. Oh no, I'm out of focus. How will I ever? Oh, right there. Okay. So I'm doing YouTube videos like this, not bad. Okay, so I need a screen to do that. Just flip it. I know it's a giant piece, that's a lot of engineering that goes into moving that. You need a crane of some sort, a crane system. Whatever happened to the Sony A99 Mark II screen? That did just, it flipped up, it turned around, it flipped down, it turned around. No one's ever doing that. I hate you all. So either give me a flip-out screen of some sort, or you're heading in wildlife territory, that EVF needs to either come with the camera or be built in. Just come with the camera. I kind of like that it tilts up, but that might F me. I'm looking at a bird, and it tilts up, but then I'm down, and it's like, I don't think that will work. I've been debating getting the Blackmagic 4K just for its 2.8K, 120 frames per second RAW with a super crop. Then you get like the Leica 200mm prime, and then that ends up like a 600 to 700 or something. And it's like, wow. Unique combinations like that could be fun. I'm just saying, I do want a cinema cam, but some things that scare me, see fast cards, what's that all about? I just got a CF Express card and a reader. What am I supposed to do now? I need a third reader? I'll read your mom a bedtime story tonight. Yeah. Just give me a CF Express card in there, or every company just decide on one card already. There's CF Express Type A, Type B, now there's C Fast, there's XQD, there's still SD cards. There's too many options. Funnel it into one thing. So to sum it up, we're doing Sony E-mount, electronic variable ND in there that auto exposes at no downside. Aperture stays the same, shutter, ISO, it's always just some type of new shit electronically darkening everything with alien technology. We're doing that, flip out screen maybe, I'd rather it flip up. A bigger battery in there, CF Express Type B cards, I think. And some new, like, maybe a higher megapixel, but then your RAW crop in a bigger, I don't know, man. I want a huge RAW crop somehow. Super slow motion. Make that like 240 frames, 2.8K raw. Until then, I don't even know you. I don't know what that was. G2? No. Not on my watch. So I'm looking. Tell me down below if I should buy the Zcam E2. I saw one. 3,200 Canadian for this package with that external monitor, batteries, CFast card, and a reader. It had everything. And I was just thinking of that. And then this ad pops up. It was like meant to be. And then we get like a Leica 200. Whoa. Should I do it? He said it auto-exposed ISO and shutter and white balance. That's auto mode for me. And then it's doing 4K 160p raw. Not raw at all. ProRes 422 or something. That could be good. So, I don't know. I think I lean that over Blackmagic anything. It's like, what are you doing? What are you even doing? EF mount? Go to sleep. I'm gonna leave. After you buy a Camera Conspiracies t-shirt. And whatever links I provided to you will be clicked. Thank you for clicking them. I'm gonna go. After you subscribe.